How's it going, horror fans? Lee and Nina here, and we're just here talking about the Berry Box House. I know I haven't said a lot about it in its relation to reality. I've just mentioned that it, you know, real things happen there in some of my videos, but today we're going to go a little more in depth into that.
Okay. So, like, one of the most important things is with the box and everything, you say that the house demanded a sacrifice, like, right off the bat.
Right off the bat.
So, yep.
The first paragraph of the Berry Box is completely 100% real. It's not fictionalized at all. That's really what happened. In fact, I left this part out, but when, after that happened, I went in the house and told my mom what happened. She fainted.
Wow, just dead out cold?
What kid, you know, I think I was, I don't know, 7, 8, 9 years old or something like that in a house.
You were small.
What kid that old says something like that?
Yeah, without it being prompted. You don't have any provocation to come up with that on your own.
Yeah, and, you know, she's since told me she saw me outside talking to the air. So, she didn't see whatever it was that was out there when that happened, but she was there when it happened. Yeah. So she saw me interacting.
But,
yeah. So, you know, among, of course, things are fictionalized in the book, but some of the stuff is real.
So, like, what else happened that you didn't put in the book? Like, what kind of things happened? Did people get, like, touched? Did they have any marks on them? Like, what
people
happened?
People definitely got touched in that house.
Okay.
There were many instances of being pushed, shoved, pulled. A common thing that would happen is if you were in the kitchen, your arm got grabbed. Things like that. Like, the house was very grabby,
like,
pushy, shovey, like...
Relation to, like, the backyard where you would have these conversations with this we're going to call it an entity thing. How does that relate to it kitchen-wise? Like, it's like behind the house is the kitchen at the back, and all this took place in the backyard.
Yeah, I mean, the house has a front door, but as most people know, like, people kind of use their back door as their main door these days, and that's how it was when I lived there in the 80s.
Okay.
So, the first room you entered in the house was the kitchen. That was your entryway room. That was your entry to the house. So that's when you first stepped into that house's boundaries, was when you walked into that kitchen.
So that was the point at which it was saying, no, we don't want you.
Pretty much. That it just, you know, there was a vibe there. And then in between the kitchen and the living room was this strange little room. It was like not much bigger than a walk-in closet. I mean, it was just this little tiny room in between the kitchen and the living room. Don't know what it was for. We didn't really use it for anything. It was just kind of there.
Was it maybe like an old entrance to the basement or something?
Like, I suppose it could have been.
Yeah.
I don't know how old the house is, but I lived there in the 80s, so it must have been around for a while. But there was no purpose to that room, and that room had a special
vibe.
Oh yeah, that was bad. When you walk through that room, and these are stories that have been told to me by my older sisters and my mom and stuff like that, when these events happened to me, but when you walk through there, it was just this shadow in the corner that seemed to be watching all the time.
Ooh, Shadow Man?
Yeah, like, it just, this looming presence in that room, you walk through it, it was just not good.
Seriously?
It was like, you kind of like hopped from the kitchen to the living room through that room as quick as you could, like, alright, let me get through here, because you did not want to be in there. It was a strange, it was just unusual.
Did your mom have like any experiences where, like, she woke up with marks on her, or there was like any evidence that something had actually physically happened?
No marks, but she definitely got like the sensation of being held down or choked in her sleep, things like that. You know, the house spoke directly to her on multiple occasions, saying that she's gonna die, we're all gonna die. Things like that. Really, really nasty stuff. I mean, a lot of that stuff I left. I mean, I put some of it in the book, but I left a lot out too, you know. And that's some of it. I think there is one instance where the house does speak, but there was a lot more in reality.
A lot more happened there than what you wrote about in the book.
Yeah, a lot more happened there.
All right, so Reggie's world was a lot more cluttered than what the book shows.
In some ways, yes. In some ways, yes. Other than the sensationalized fictional parts.
Right. Of course.
But But the reality of it is a little darker than the fictional world that I wrote about.
Yeah, well, the place has definitely has a creepy vibe to it.
Very much so.
Yeah. And you have that old picture of it?
Yes.
The old picture of the house?
If you notice, I did put up a picture of the house. I went through the photo albums and found one.
One. Mom kept one.
Yeah, we had one picture of the house that somehow
putting that behind her.
ended up in there. So luckily I was able to find that. So I did put that up. If you want to see the actual Berry Box house from what it looked like from the street.
Back when you lived there, not now.
Yeah, it's an older picture, right. Yeah. I don't know what it looks like now, but basically, you know, because I went there at night and snuck in through the back, and that's the only shot you really got to see was like a little bit of me lighting up the back of the house. So
yeah, and you couldn't see much of it. You could basically just see the dirt.
Yeah, so I was really glad to find an actual picture of it so you could see the house as a whole.
Back in the day.
Back in the day, yeah. When it was terrorizing my family.
Yeah. Happy times.
Yeah, right? But, you know, the good side of it is it did inspire a book. It's one of the things that inspired me to be a writer, and I wanted to write about this story.
I was just going to ask you, so did any of that experience that happened at the Berry Box house, is that part of what drove you or, you know, kind of gave you this passion for horror writing?
I think I was born with it, but I'd say it definitely drove me to not only be a fan of horror, but to actually write it. Because like I said, my mom was a horror fan, my grandfather was a horror fan, he was in the Boris Karloff fan club.
Had your grandfather ever been to this Berry Box house?
I'm sure he did.
Okay, yeah. You just don't remember, you were young?
Yeah, I was too young, but I'm sure he's been there.
Okay.
But it was a horrible, horrible place.
So when you guys moved, why did you actually move out because of what was happening in the house?
Yeah, definitely. We could not stay there.
Was too much?
Yeah.
Constant?
Yeah, we had to move. It was so menacing and so terrifying to be there.
Yeah, and plus your mother was probably terrified that you were going to actually try and hurt yourself in the backyard because the police were telling you to.
Yeah, I mean, I literally got told to bury myself.
get buried.
Yeah.
The new tell-off phrase, get buried.
That was kind of the idea, you know, because that's what the house told me to do, was to get buried.
Wow.
To bury myself, and that's where that, a lot of that came from.
Not
also,
only is that creepy, but that's like the most horrific death. To like not have air and be trapped.
Yeah, I'd say so.
God.
Claustrophobia.
Yeah, no thank you.
Stuck in the dark, no way out, you're trapped. All you have is the time to know that.
Your time's running out.
Yeah.
Damn.
It's a pretty terrible death, so.
And the house suggested it.
Yeah.
So there's no sanctuary. It's like you can't get out of the dirt and run inside.
So, just wanted to tell you a little bit, a little deeper history of the Berry Box house. If you have any questions about it or anything like that, feel free to comment on the post. I'll be happy to answer them. And make sure to enter the contest with the comment hashtag GetBurried. There's going to be 13 winners. It's going to be awesome.
And feel free to throw your 2 cents in. So, you got a story to tell? Share it. Put it out there. Drop it on a Berry Box post. We do this all the time. We end up laughing. All right, guys. Thank you for listening. Thanks for listening to Lee's story.
Thanks for watching.
It was nice to get a little more info than what I've had going through. And we will catch you guys later. Don't forget to enter. Hashtag get buried.
Get buried, motherfuckers.
Yeah.